In the first section of this course, we'll look closely at each type of variation: pre-analytical, analytical, and biological. Variation in a test result is expected because of factors before and during testing. We can never know the true value of an analyte. Controlling variation is critical to ensuring every result reported is as close to the true value as possible. Too much variation can result in the reporting of erroneous patient test results, leading to misdiagnosis, an incorrect prognosis, or an inappropriate treatment plan for the patient. Frequent reporting of erroneous results by a laboratory will seriously diminish its credibility and may result in liability. We'll begin with pre-analytical variation and its causes. Pre-analytical variation occurs prior to the analysis of a sample. Three main areas susceptible to pre-analytical variation are patient preparation, specimen collection, specimen transportation. When preparing a patient for specimen collection, the instructions given to the patient need to be clear and consistent. The patient should be able to demonstrate an understanding of the instructions. For example, numerous tests require a patient to fast. The patient will need to know what fasting is and for how long they should fast before specimen collection. Here are two additional examples. Aspirin can falsely elevate bleeding times. A patient will need to know she must stop taking aspirin for a period of days before a bleeding time test is performed. High levels of vitamin C can cause a false positive for glucose in the urine. A patient taking excess amounts of vitamin C may need to stop taking it prior to a urinalysis test. Adherence to approved specimen collection procedures is important to control pre-analytical variation. During blood collection, the following errors can adversely affect the integrity of a specimen: leaving a tourniquet on the arm, ankle, or hand too long can cause an elevation in some analytes. The position of a patient as a blood sample is drawn can also lead to variation. For example, outpatients who tend to have their blood collected while seated can have values 5% higher for some tests when compared to their inpatient counterparts who generally lie down for blood collection. Using a collection tube containing the incorrect anticoagulant for a test can cause error in a result. For example, a light gray top collection tube contains sodium fluoride and potassium oxalate, agents that preserve glucose. If a different anticoagulant is used, a lower level of glucose could be reported. Hemolysis, the breakage of red blood cells, can cause the increase of certain analytes due to leakage of red cell components into the surrounding fluid. It can also cause interference in tests using, for example, a spectrophotometric method. Other factors that can affect the pre-analytical variation of a result are issues with specimen transport. Cellular metabolism within a specimen continues after collection. If there's either a significant delay in delivery, or for some analytes, the sample is transported at the wrong temperature, there can be a significant impact on the results. Use of a good quality assurance program helps to control pre-analytical variation. When controlled, this type of variation can be negligible, contributing little to the overall variation of a result. Let's review what we've learned about pre-analytical variation. Pre-analytical variation is any variation that occurs prior to the analysis of a sample. Three main areas susceptible to pre-analytical variation are patient preparation, specimen collection, specimen transportation. Pre-analytical variation can be and should be controlled. For all of your laboratory QC needs, go to www.qcnet.com.